guys, it's Theodore, and in this video, you're going to learn the professional persuasion methods that marketers and salesmen use to sell things. After watching this whole video, you'll probably be the most persuasive person in your family, and you might even literally be able to sell someone a pin. I have used this very method to sell literally tens of thousands of dollars of my online course, The Psychology of Attraction, and today I'm releasing these secrets to you. In this video, I'm going to talk about three main sales methods, along with the core reason anyone buys anything and how they justify their purchase so that they're actually happy about the transaction. Before we get into the content, I just want to say that I've already used this method in this video, so if you're still watching, it's just proof that it works on you. But be careful, by the end of this video, I might have convinced you to hand over your wallet. So the first method we're going to talk about is called the 4 P's of personal selling. The first P stands for promise. Promise is basically the hook, how you get consumers' attention. Movie trailers do a great job of this, and so do book titles. In the beginning of the video, I stated, you could be the most persuasive person in your family. That's called the hook. That's the promise. Wouldn't it be wonderful to be that persuasive? When you sell someone to something, you need a promise. The second P stands for picture. Now, when you're selling something, you have to be creative. I want you to imagine being so confident that you could walk up to any girl you wanted to and effortlessly have a conversation that you have complete control of. No anxiety, no sweaty pits, no stuttering. You just have her in awe and her gorgeous eyes are on you the entire time. What I just did was paint a picture in your head. Now, this picture is actually something similar that I used to sell my dating course. If you want to check it out, there's a link in the description. In the beginning of this video, I said, you might be able to literally sell someone a pin. That's the picture that I painted for this video. People buy with emotion and potential, and that's very important. It's also something I'm going to talk about later in this video. Make the buy picture a fantasy in their head of what could happen with your product. It's very important, though, that the fantasy is realistic. Otherwise, you'll have a boatload of refunds and be out of business quicker than you can shake a stick at. The third P is proof. So after someone buys your product, what will happen? Did the picture you painted actually come true? Proof could be testimonials, a reference from an authority figure, or just word of mouth. Make sure that your product actually works, and then boast about it. For example, on my course sales page, I show tons of emails from guys who have actually had success from the course, and some are even brave enough to do a video testimonial to verify that they're real people. In the beginning of this video, I said that I had used these methods to sell tens of thousands of dollars of my course, and that was the proof that this process worked. I also told you that I was already using them, and if you're still watching, it's because they worked on you. And you know what? I bet that hooked you, and you're still watching, aren't you? You can tell people all day long, but the second that you show them something, they'll stick around, especially if you trick them and they want to know how something works. Now, the last P stands for push, or also known as pitch. The pitch is the part of the sales process when you introduce the product and ask for a buy. There are tons of psychological effects you can introduce to make the buyer more likely to buy, but I'm going to give you three right now. The first one is scarcity. If you make something limited edition or only available for a short period of time, people panic and their fear of missing out causes them to want it more. The second one is social proof. So when you can make a product seem so great that other people are using it, more people will buy it. They'll trust it more. Imagine if the past 20 presidents used this product. So does Robert Downey Jr. and actually your mom does too. Well, because of that, you're going to be more likely to buy the product than if nobody you know and trust is using it. The third thing is paradox of choice. When you give someone more than 4 choices, their brain starts to steam, like it becomes a decision of which one to buy instead of whether to buy or not. You know that they want to buy and you want to make the buying process as easy as possible. So try as hard as possible to give them one call to action. And if not, give them 2 or 3, but never go over 3. Studies have proven this over and over and your sales will decrease. So that was the 4 P's of personal selling. There's also another method called the 4 P's of marketing. And the 4 P's of marketing are a little older, but they're also more foundational. You should have these in the back of your mind whenever you're trying to sell something. The first P is product. All right, do you think a 40-year-old man is gonna wanna buy high heels? Actually, never mind, don't answer that question. My point is, even if you have the best hair growth cream out there, some people either already have a head full of beautiful locks, or they just don't care about their bald spot. You can only sell to people who want or need your product. And you can't get mad at the 40-year-old guy who doesn't want high heels. Now, there is an advanced version of marketing where you can sell him high heels for his wife's birthday, but we'll talk about that later. The second P of marketing is called price. There are going to be people who just don't have $300 to spend on your product. And there are also going to be people who don't want to waste $3 on your product because they see it as something cheap. Picking price is very important, and I might do a whole nother video on this, so subscribe if you haven't already. The third P of marketing is placement. So where can someone get your product? Is it online? Is it in stores? This was more important before internet marketing and Shopify, because now you can literally buy a car and have it driven to your front door. But 20 years ago, if you needed shampoo, you had to go to the local superstore. This was just to make sure that when your customers made the decision to buy, they could actually go through the buying process. And it was easy. The last P of marketing is promotion. So how are people actually gonna know about your product? Are you giving away free samples? Are you doing YouTube ads? Are you becoming a viral meme, word of mouth? Make sure that you have a good promotional strategy so the guy who actually wants that balding cream sees your ad first. The last method of selling I'm gonna talk about is called the AIDA method, which stands for AIDA. The ADA method is a way to funnel just average consumers into being a customer who takes action. So the first letter stands for awareness. If you want to sell something, the first thing you need is attention. And you can get attention by buying Facebook ads, telling your friends, posting for YouTube videos, or just blogging. You have to get to someone's attention first. The I stands for interest. To get interest, you need to be interesting. Make sure your marketing is focusing on the benefits people receive once they own your product. Anyone can see your advertisement, but you want to make sure that their focus is on the advertisement. If I tell you, this dating course will help you with all of your relationships and walk you through getting, finding, and keeping any girl you like, that is not as interesting as, this dating course has been approved by a team of psychologists and a marriage therapist so that the information is fundamentally sound and the tools provided will skyrocket your confidence so that you can talk to any girl you want to with absolutely no anxiety and have complete control of the entire conversation. That has many more buzzwords, and people are more likely to be interested. The D stands for desires. So, when most people try to sell something, they try to sell it logically. This monitor has 4K resolution with 144Hz refresh rate and is 34 inches diagonally. No, that's not what most people buy from. You have to make them desire it. This monitor is simply breathtaking, top-of-the-line graphics that most people don't even own yet. When you watch an action movie, you will feel like you're actually in the jungle fighting off lions, or in New York City fighting off aliens yourself. You might even forget it's a movie. If you want to hook your computer up to this monitor, you'll be able to do 4 times as much work if you had a 1080p monitor. And just imagine what you could do if you could accomplish 4 times as many tasks throughout the day. See, we tied in some promises and pictures here and there to help the customer desire the product. We had their awareness with an ad, and then we had their interest because when we set up the ad, we targeted people who were in the market to buy a new monitor, and then we drove them home with a desire to buy this monitor. The last part of this formula is action. So after you've got their attention, interest, and really made them desire your product, you can introduce the offer. Remember our 3 tips that I gave you earlier from the 4 P's of selling hacks, scarcity, social proof, and the paradox of choice? Well, I'm gonna give you 2 more tips to increase your call to action conversion rate. The first one is objection handling. So right before anyone buys anything, if you handle their rejections, you know, their what if questions, then you can almost double or triple your sales instantly. Some people call this a frequently asked questions section, but make sure that you have common questions ready and the answers memorized. What if this product doesn't work? Well, tell them that there's a money back guarantee. What if I can't make YouTube videos because I think I sound weird? Well, with this program, we teach you how to hire other expert voiceover artists. What if I feel uncomfortable around girls? Well, my exposure therapy process will help you feel comfortable around girls without any painful experiences. The basic idea here is to make them feel smart for buying your product. Tip number 2 is anchoring. So anchoring is a really cool psychological marketing tactic that a lot of marketers use. Have you ever wanted to buy a course and it says, this premium body language course costs over $300,000 to make, and experts said they'd pay $997 for it, but you can get it today at a low price of $47? Well, the first number you heard was 300,000, which automatically makes your brain go, oh my goodness, this is a top-notch production quality body language course I've ever seen. Then the second number of $997 makes you think, wow, if experts pay that much and they already know most of the body language secrets, I wonder what I could get out of it. But I don't think I can do that because $997 is like half the price of my car. Then you get blown away by the super small number of $47. Hey, I can afford that. Heck, I spend that much money on coffee or eating out each month. I'll explain anchoring in another video simply because there's a lot more to it than this, but I just wanted you to understand how marketers do it in the sales process. One more thing before we end this video I want you to know is that people buy with emotion and they justify with logic. One of the most important things you need to remember when selling or writing copy is that people buy with emotion and they justify with logic. Oh my goodness, I need this, otherwise I'll be lonely for the rest of my life. And it's only $47 and comes with a ton of bonuses. See, most purchases are actually impulse buys if you think about it, but then they slowly become good decisions in the mind of the consumer once the logic comes in and starts justifying the purchase. They think about it more and more and start to justify their purchase, whether it was actually a good deal or not. If you're interested in selling things better, this is just a sample video. I'm putting together a full course on pricing, anchoring, priming, discounting, scarcity, other selling methods, negotiation tactics, and just everything you need to know to learn how to sell things in person and online, and I'm gonna launch it pretty soon. The first people to join will get it at a discounted price, and all you have to do is sign up to my email list by clicking on my top 10 book list or 31 confidence hacks links in the description, and then you just confirm your email. See? Always a pitch. This whole video was a pitch, and you didn't even notice because I used a method of selling that I didn't talk about in this video. Anyways, I might talk about it later. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and learned something, and here's to you growing your sales skills.